Warning, what you are about to see is something you're probably either gonna love or hate. When you guys thought I couldn't do anything crazier to the Tacoma build. Welcome back to the Tacomaholic channel, everybody. If this is your first time stopping by and you love everything related to Tacomas and cicadas, apparently, go ahead and subscribe now. All right, guys, now if my calculations are correct, carry the one. Yeah, this should be the first live shot of the second gen Tacoma goat armor that you guys have seen. In case you didn't know, Goat Armor is a company that makes these thin magnetic panels that help protect your paint underneath while also giving your truck or vehicle a little bit of style. You can mix and match all kinds of different colors to get that perfect style you are looking for while also protecting your paint from those hideous natural pinstripings we sometimes collect while out on the trail. I've been in contact with Matt over at the Goat Armor website, and he has been super helpful with me with picking this out. I will go over the Goat Armor in just a second, but huge shout out to him for getting this out to me super fast so I could be the first one you guys see. You know I like to be first. Now, the Goat Armor has been around for a while for third gen Tacomas, Forerunners, all kinds of other things. I will of course put their website in the link below, but the second gen has just been uploaded to their website, I think this past week. And like I mentioned before, I've been in contact with Matt, the owner of the Goat Armor company, and he was able to get this out to me so I could display it and showcase it for you guys in all of its glory and help spread the word, of course. Now, there are tons of different like templates you can get. This is the Hexco edition. You can see it right there. And one thing I like about this is you can change any of the colors you want to whatever colors they have available. This specific one is based off the cement Tacoma color for the third gens. You can get it for the second gen version for the Goat Armor. That's what this color is on the back, actually. And I sort of plugged and played with the front colors. This is usually like white up here. I had them do this black. And while I'm mentioning it, since the sun's hitting it just right, this is the matte version. For all of the Goat Armor items, you can get either matte or gloss. Obviously, I like the matte since the vinyl wrap underneath is also matte. Looks really good there, popping in the sunlight. But I had them do the front part here, matte black, with their orange for the topographic lines right there, which I absolutely love. I mean, it's not an exact match, of course, and I was fine with that, but it's pretty close, especially like from a little farther back, you can see. And then the same orange on the diagonal slash, separated with a small matte black, then a dark gray, and then the cement for the back. One thing I initially did ask Matt about is if they are able to actually remove like the mountains right there on the bedside and the rear door, and he said they aren't able to do that even though they are able to change all the colors. But actually, now that I have it, I'm glad I didn't have them remove the mountains. It just sort of helps set it apart just a little bit, even though those slashes are certainly cool. Definitely glad I have the mountains still attached. And one other quick thing to mention, I do have the tailgate done. I'll show you that in just a second. And obviously the driver's side. I have not installed the passenger side, simply because, of course, I need to, I mean, I can do all the back doors once I remove that. That's just on there with double-sided tape. I need to remove my snorkel, obviously, and then I guess set the Goat Armor on this piece, put the snorkel on it, and I was thinking about just cutting out a hole for the main, obviously where the snorkel passes through the fender and then all the bolt holes. But I think what I'm gonna do is just trim the Goat Armor up to where it just tucks right here on the line. There's like a finger gap under there. I don't know, it's, I mean, it's pretty much tight right there, so I could pretty much chop off this back piece and then the skinny piece for the top and then the front piece, but I don't know. Comment below, let me know what you guys think I should do, if I should just trim around the snorkel right there, which would obviously make it easier if I ever wanted to remove the Goat Armor to clean it or whatever, which of course probably recommended every week or so, or should I just make holes and mount the snorkel on top of that? Let me know what you guys think. And of course, comment below. I'd love to hear your thoughts on if you like what I did to the truck with this Goat Armor color theme. It's definitely unique. You got to give me that. Love it or hate it. Definitely makes the truck pop a little bit. And while I'm looking at it, yes, I got a best top, haven't done a video on this. Stay tuned for that also. And because of the color choices I picked, there are, I mean, some of like the gaps between the panels, which is, that's just the way it is. They're a little more noticeable than usual just because the, you know, my truck is orange underneath versus like cement, like I mentioned. So if this was a cement truck, all of this would blend in nicely, but it is what it is. At first, it sort of bothered me, but as I look at it, it sort of blends in because there's so much going on, you really don't notice it after a little while, especially with all those topographic lines. These pieces do go on relatively easily for some of the longer pieces, like the big door pieces and obviously the bedside. If you have two people, that's gonna add years to your life, just doing those micro adjustments, since once it's on, you can't really slide it, you risk scratching anything underneath. Sort of put it off, put it back on, but I mean, realistically, doing this side, it probably just took 10 minutes, and it felt like longer just because it's in the summer heat, but not too bad looking back. And while we're back here, here is the tailgate piece. Again, it's pretty much lined up perfectly. I used the tailgate handle as like the base moving forward. It lines up nice and tight against the top line right there. I wish the bottom part was extended a little more, and I wish there was like another half inch on either side, but again, since the tailgate underneath is not cement, it definitely shows up a little bit more. Got the nice Goat Off-Road Armor Tech logo right there, you can see. Something I'm flirting about doing for this bottom piece is, and I just threw it on there, but something I'm flirting with doing for the bottom piece is this large white piece right here is just excess from where you get a giant roll with all the pieces on it, and you sort of, they're sort of perforated around the edge, so you peel off each piece as you install it. This is a long straight piece. I am thinking about cutting that to size just to match the width on either side of the tailgate. And then down, I guess, to this line right here. I think that was 2.5 inches by 55.5 wide. And then maybe getting some kind of matte black wrap to wrap on top of that. So that'll just help break up that bottom line just a little bit and sort of cover some of that orange to help it make it blend in. Comment below, let me know what you think of that idea. And aside from that, that is pretty much it, everyone. Just wanted to show you guys, to hopefully be the first one you see for the second gen version of the Goat Armor. Again, this is the Hexco edition. They have plenty of other things and they can do custom stuff for you, I assume, if you send them like the necessary files. And of course, that would probably be an extra charge, but comment below, let me know what you think of this on my truck. Love it or hate it, you have to admit, it definitely makes it pop. And if you plan on getting some second gen Goat Armor for yourself. Alright guys, that will do it for this video. Comment below, let me know what you think of the entire setup now. Can't wait to hear what you guys think. As always, thank you so much for supporting the channel by watching this video. Enjoy the rest of your week, and I'll see you in the next video.